What SpaceX has done to transform the entire space industry is just phenomenal. SpaceX has hit milestones and made achievements that no other private space company has managed to make. It has made it to the top of the private space company list in the industry. And now that it is performing some of the launches in collaboration with NASA, SpaceX is destined for more growth. It is bound to get to levels that we have not seen any other private space company get to. But what is SpaceX's most recent achievement? Hello everyone, and welcome back to Liftoff. Today, we're going to take a look at the Falcon 9 rocket from SpaceX that has just launched an Egyptian Nilesat 301. Make sure that you watched till the end to find out more, and subscribe to our channel for all things Elon Musk, space and technology. And with that, let's see what Elon Musk has done. When Elon Musk was starting SpaceX, he only had one vision, to go to Mars. This vision somehow transformed into a startup company that was shaking up the entire space industry and a fleet of new rockets. And now, those rockets are the ones that are transporting people from Florida to the International Space Station. In fact, it was the first time that a for-profit company carried astronauts into orbit. This was a milestone in the effort of commercializing space, but it was so much more than that for SpaceX. It was more of a new milestone in a wild ride, which began with some serious issues and even a threat of bankruptcy. However, this is said to be the beginning because the founder and CEO has been planning to build a city on the red planet and even live there. While in Mexico in 2016, Musk told a cheering Congress of space professionals, "What I really want to achieve here is to make Mars seem possible. Make it seem as though it's something that we can do in our lifetimes and that you can go." Because of what Musk has done with SpaceX, there are a lot of scientists out there who are showing their support and even driving it towards more. According to Harvard University astrophysicist Jonathan McDowell, Musk is a revolutionary change in the space world. In addition to that, Mitchell Lopez Algeria, an ex-astronaut and former Commercial Spaceflight Federation chief, said, "I think history will look back at him like a Da Vinci figure." Musk has become famous mainly because of Tesla, which is a company that he headed to build some of the best electric vehicles in the world. And now, he has SpaceX, which was his from the start. By the time Musk was hitting 30 years old, he was already a millionaire because he had just sold his internet financial company, PayPal, and its predecessor, Zip2. During this time, he arranged for a couple of lunches in Silicon Valley in 2001 with G. Scott Hubbard. By then, Scott was NASA's Mars czar while still running the agency's Ames Research Center. However, according to Hubbard, Musk just wanted to head over to Mars and show it to the world, with the hope that it would inspire school children. Hubbard said that his real focus was having life on Mars. However, when Hubbard was advising him, he told him that the hardest part was coming up with a rocket that would be affordable enough to go to Mars. And less than a year after he had this discussion with Elon Musk, SpaceX was born. Just like all the other space companies out there, SpaceX was also designed for profit. However, what separates SpaceX from the rest is that it has a goal behind its profit motive. This goal is simply going to Mars. According to McDowell, by having that longer-term vision, that's pushed them to be more ambitious and really change things. According to Garrett Reisman, who is the former SpaceX Director of Space Operations, everyone working at SpaceX, all the way from senior vice presidents to the barista who offers the company's in-house cappuccinos and frozen yogurt, is working towards making humans multi-planetary. When Musk was founding SpaceX, NASA had still ramped up the notion of commercial space. Traditionally, NASA would stay dominant in the market because all other private firms would build things and provide services for NASA. This was a way to ensure that NASA stayed as the dominant space company. For more than 50 years, there has been the idea of bigger roles for private companies, but the market and technology were not yet ready for that. But what changed everything was NASA's two deadly space shuttle accidents. These were with the Challenger in 1986 and Columbia in 2003. When Columbia disintegrated, NASA had to contemplate a post-space shuttle world. And now, that is where private companies come in. After Columbia, the agency now had two things to do. This was to return astronauts to the moon while still getting cargo and astronauts to the International Space Station. This was according to O'Keefe, who was NASA's administrator at the time. And so, in 2005, a pilot project was launched that would help private companies develop ships that were powerful enough to take cargo to the station. SpaceX was one of the companies to receive the initial funding. But even with that, the first three launches of the company failed. Normally, this could have been the end of the company, but NASA stuck by SpaceX, and soon they started to see some results. And so, since 2010, NASA has spent more than $6 billion just to help private companies get people into orbit, with the greatest beneficiaries of all this being SpaceX and Boeing. NASA has some big plans for SpaceX, as they are already the main suppliers of cargo to the International Space Station. But SpaceX did not stay there, and it is now bigger. While still pursuing their dream of getting to Mars, they are also performing other launches, such as the most recent launch of the Egyptian satellite. SpaceX's Falcon 9 rocket launched on Wednesday from Cape Canaveral with a telecom satellite for Egypt's Nilesat aboard. This was in the launch of the Nilesat 301 telecom satellite that was being launched with the help of SpaceX. The Falcon 9 lifted off at around 5:04 p.m. EDT, and the first stage booster managed to land on SpaceX's drone ship in the Atlantic Ocean. The Falcon 9 rocket, which stands at 229 feet tall, launched from Pad 40 at Cape Canaveral Space Force Station in Florida. This was the beginning of the 33-minute mission that would place the 9,000-pound Nilesat 301 spacecraft into an elongated transfer orbit that ranges in the tens of thousands of miles above the Earth. Nilesat 301 is set to operate at a position in geostationary orbit that is more than 22,000 miles over the equator at 7 degrees west longitude. From here, it will be able to provide TV broadcast and internet services all over Egypt and other parts of Africa and the Middle East. To reach its operational orbit, the spacecraft will use its own propulsion system for the final maneuvers. The launch that took place on Wednesday was the 23rd launch of the Falcon 9 rocket this year. It was also the first launch with a satellite heading toward geostationary orbit, a popular location for TV broadcasting and data relay spacecraft. This was also the first truly commercial launch into a geostationary transfer orbit worldwide. Sometime in the past, the geostationary satellite launch market was once very lucrative for launch providers such as SpaceX. However, the satellite market has mostly shifted to smaller spacecraft, which includes a constellation that is comprised of lower altitude orbits that beam broadband signals to consumers. SpaceX is the parent company of the Starlink network, which is currently the world's largest fleet of satellites. Other companies are also trying to deploy their own constellations, but SpaceX already has the upper hand when it comes to this. The Starlink network is a network of satellites that are meant to provide internet capabilities all over the world through satellite connections. So far, the network has more than 2,200 satellites that are in orbit, and they are all fully functional. SpaceX has built these satellites with some of the latest technology to provide internet access to some countries. However, this network is said to grow to about 30,000 satellites, but we have yet to find out more. SpaceX has really achieved a lot, and from the look of things, they are not going to stop until they get to Mars and start a colony there. This is a space company with a mission and a vision, and it is headed by a very eccentric but driven CEO who is capable of doing it. What do you think of SpaceX and its current state? Feel free to let us know in the comments section below. Also, be sure to subscribe to our channel for all things Elon Musk, space, and technology. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you next time.